Good day. This is another lecture in our series on the South African maternity case record. In this case, an exercise on completing the partogram. For this exercise, it would be good if you can have an empty partogram or a copy of the partogram on which to practice. I'm just going to give you the detail of the specific exercise and then I'm going to plot it on the partogram. So in this case, it's a 41-year-old woman, gravid of 5, para 3, miscarriage 1. At 40 weeks pregnancy, she only attended clinic once, so she booked late. HIV is negative, VDRL negative, and RH positive. She was admitted in labor. She was examined on the 1st of January 2020 at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, with 3 strong contractions in 10 minutes. The membranes ruptured spontaneously at 5 o'clock. And contraction started at 6 o'clock. In speculum examination, he was clear fluid draining. In terms of observations, the blood pressure is 100 over 60, the pulse is 67 beats per minute, and she passed 100 mL of urine, and dipstick shows no glucose, no proteins, and no ketones. Her temperature was 37 degrees Celsius. On auscultation of the fetal heart rate, it was 140 beats per minute before contraction and 140 beats per minute after a contraction. Abdominal examination shows a term singleton baby in longitudinal lie with cephalic presentation with the back on the left side and 2/5 head above brim. Vaginal examination showed a cervix that was fully effaced, 6 cm dilated, lift occipital anterior position, there was no caput and no molding, and the application was good. So it may be a good idea to pause the video at this stage and just make sure you get all this detail and then continue with the video and see how it is plotted on the partogram. So let's start with the completion of the partogram. Good. So the partogram you can see in front of you with the latent phase on the one side, the active phase on the other side. This patient is 41 years old, so we can already start with her name. Let's write Mrs. Smith. Age is 41, which is already a warning sign that she's of advanced maternal age. Gravidity is 5, parity 3, miscarriage 1. And risk factors, she booked late. And what else? She only attended clinic once, so there's advanced maternal age. So we've missed an opportunity in this patient to do genetic screening early on in pregnancy. The date is the 1st of January 2020, which we can write in the date block there. Okay, so HIV negative, VDRL negative, and RH positive. She's admitted in labor. We examine her on the 1st of January at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So the first thing we have to decide is where are we going to plot this patient. So we know she's getting strong contractions and 6 centimeters dilated, but she's already in the active phase. And we always start on the first line or the warning line, and we look at 6 centimeters because that's how far she's dilated. And this will determine where we put the 2 o'clock, which is 1400 hours in the afternoon. So this line now becomes 2 o'clock, and we can put 2 o'clock on top. And every block after this will now be an hour, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, etc. 6 centimeters on the warning line, and everything we plot for 2 o'clock will be either on this line, if it's possible to write on the line, or if it's a block, you just write it to the right of the line. Good, so let's carry on. Membranes ruptured spontaneously, so we can tick the spontaneous block. And the time of rupture of membranes was 5 o'clock in the morning. The question there is duration of labor on arrival. So we know she started with contractions at 6 o'clock, and she arrives 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So from 6 o'clock in the morning, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, is 8 hours. So duration of labor on arrival is already 8 hours. And there's another block for that, duration in hours right below the time. So at 2 o'clock, she was ready 8 hours in labor. And again, we can just keep on plotting 9, 10 hours, 11 hours, 12 hours, 13 hours. So by 6 o'clock, she would be 12 hours in labor. That's just an indication of how long labor has been going on. So let us look at the general observations. Blood pressure is 100 over 60. So we use the 2 o'clock line and we plot the blood pressure 100 over 60 using arrows. And the pulse is 67 per minute, so that's a little dot at 67. Urine passed 100 milliliters, and we can put that in the urine block. Volume is 100 mils. I would just write to the right of the line. No proteins, there are no ketones, 1 plus blood, and no glucose. And the temperature is 37 degrees. All of those go in the block, just to the right of the line. We can just at the bottom put the time again, 2 o'clock, to make sure that everything here is happening at 2 o'clock. Okay, let's start top now and look at the fetal heart rate. So at 2 o'clock, the fetal heart rate is 140 beats per minute. So we can write this just to the right of the line, 140 beats. And there's also 140 beats after a contraction, meaning there are no decelerations. And in the deceleration block, we can circle no decelerations. If there were decelerations, we would have put in this block below either early, variable, or late, an EV or an L, depending on what it is. But definitely no decelerations. Liker was clear, the abbreviation for that is C. So again, we can just write a C there for clear Liker. Let us look at the head above brim. Head above brim was 2/5. So on the 2 o'clock line, we can plot the head above brim 2/5. So we use the 2 there for that. And there the head is 2/5. And hopefully as labor progresses, the head will descend as we go along. Okay, it's a cephalic presentation. So in the presenting part, we can write cephalic. There are no caput, there's no molding, and the application is good. So all of that goes into that to the right of the line. The position is left occipital anterior, so we can write in that block left occipital anterior. Additionally, you can also indicate left occipital anterior using the head above brim. So now we've completed the fetal assessment, the vaginal assessment, the abdominal assessment. We have to look at the contraction. She's getting 3 strong contractions. So at 2 o'clock, there are 3 strong contractions. They are completed. She's not getting any oxytocin, so we can leave that out, and the rest observations are done. Compartogram is completed. All you need to do is put in a management plan, sign your name at the bottom, and then with each successive examination, you would plot her again on the line. So the next examination in her case would probably be in about 4 hours' time, so around about 5 o'clock in the afternoon, 3, 4, 5, 6 o'clock would be 4 hours. Then she's 12 hours in labor, and hopefully by that time she would be fully dilated.